Well, does it feel like Monday's storm kind of came out of nowhere?
It's like we expected it, but not quite like this or this much. Here to explain, Alex Tardy with the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. We are joined also by, of course, Ms. Chrissy Russo. Alex, good morning to you.
Good morning. Thanks for having me on again.
So I think the main question here is not did we see the storm coming, because obviously we did, but did you see this kind of storm coming? We were talking 3 inches of rain in 3 hours in some parts of San Diego.
Yeah, you described it very accurately. So we saw this particular storm series coming through a week in advance, and we expected a lot of rain and even heavy rain. But when it came down to how much rain fell in downtown San Diego, National City, El Cajon, we didn't expect that intensity until it was actually occurring, or basically until it was on weather radar. It was 1 to 1.5 inches per hour.
Is it just because it just didn't show up? I brought it up yesterday. I was talking and asking Chrissy and the team about it. I said, remember when the hurricane was coming and everybody was like, oh, you're making such a big deal about the hurricane, and it just kind of, you know, bypasses, thankfully. But then this storm, it was just a storm, caused so much more damage than what we saw as we were preparing for this hurricane to hit.
Yeah, that's a great question. You know, the computer models that we use a day or two before showed very heavy rain, as much as an inch per hour. But the problem is the location. So sometimes they show like Carlsbad, which did get heavy rain. And then they shifted over to Escondido, then it shifts over to La Jolla. So the exact location, like a day before, is nearly almost possible. With Hillary, it was kind of a different story, though, because Hillary, the county, the city, got 1 to 3 inches of rain. You know, my house had almost 3 inches of rain, just under. But the difference was it was distributed gently throughout the entire day or 24 hours, where this rain on Monday, 2 to 3 hours, it all came down.
Yeah, a little too much too fast.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And, you know, Alex, in my experience in forecasting this particular event on, you know, there was just a lot of variation in the models the week before. And it seemed anomalous in the way that, you know, every year these models get better and better, and they are so precise and so good sometimes, it's kind of eerie. In this particular case, I don't know if you had the same experience with your interpretation of all the different data that's out there. Did you see a lot of different forecasts coming out of the National Weather Service for Monday, like I did the week before? I mean, we're talking days before, so it's not gonna be as reliable, but was your experience like mine at all?
Yeah, it certainly was. And it's often like that. So for example, with this particular storm on Monday, when we were doing webinars and posting things on social media, we were messaging 1 to 3 inches of rain. But we were saying storm one, which was Saturday afternoon, and then storm two, which was Monday. Storm one happened, and we had a half inch to an inch everywhere on Saturday afternoon. Sunday we had a break, but then on Monday, storm two was, you know, triple the amount of rain as storm one, but it also was the intensity. It came in faster and harder, and that's really what results in your flash flooding anywhere in the country, is the intensity, the magnitude, coming all down at once. Really no drainage system can get rid of it when it rains that hard. So, you know, a lot of times when we message 2 to 3 inches of rain for this event, for example, the one thing we really need to improve on, and the models need to improve on, is how quick will that rain will come down. Mm-hmm. 2 to 3 inches of rain is a lot, but if it comes down in 2 to 3 hours, what a world of difference, like in the photos that are shown here.
Now, does that include the excessive rainfall forecast product that's put out? That's a pretty good product. Would something like that, that information, be included in that output? And is that something that we could communicate from just what we already have, or what we can always improve? But I wonder if the excessive rainfall forecast is something that would also have a lot of that information already.
Yeah, that product, excessive rainfall outlook, and the product flood watch that we issued on Sunday for San Diego County, for downtown San Diego, the flood watch and the excessive rain outlook indications with that, what we're trying to message are, heavy rain is coming, certainly, and flooding is possible. But we can't really pinpoint the location and the severity often in those situations. So when we say flood watch like we did on Sunday, and then you see the excessive rain outlook painted over Southern California or over San Diego in this case, we're trying to indicate there's going to be a variety of flooding, river flooding, flash flooding, urban flooding. But we still, in those type of products, don't necessarily indicate the sheer magnitude. A lot of times these disasters, like we saw here, just in general, the specific intensity of them are not predictable until almost when they're happening.
You know, I tell you what, the forecasting game is a difficult one, and it's credit to you guys, Alex, and what Chrissy does, that people's expectations now are at a point where, like, why didn't you tell me that on my block I was going to get 3 feet of water? This is still Mother Nature, and the expectation from people, to your credit, they expect you to tell them exactly where they live, what's going to happen, and how it's going to happen. Are those unrealistic expectations at this point? Because you guys are trying to predict where it's going to go. You know it's going to rain, but it seems almost like you can't win here.
Yeah. So the situation we have now is we have a lot of different tools from, you know, 5 days before, a week before, all the way up to an hour before. In this scenario here, we used all those tools. In fact, we used a flash flood warning about, you know, the time it was raining really hard or right before for downtown San Diego. And that went to everyone's smartphone. They went to their TV and radio through the emergency alert system. But at that point, it's almost like shelter in place when you're in a flash flood warning. There's not much else you can do. You certainly can't stop it. You can't put up sandbags. It's really almost too late. So we used all those tools, but you're right. The expectations are really high. So our computer models and the tools we have do have the ability to say, okay, X location will receive this much rain or this much snow or this much wind. But the problem is the exact location is not going to be accurate most of the time. And people will get frustrated if they hear, hey, I'm going to get 3 inches of rain. And then when the storm actually hits, it's Carlsbad and not San Diego.
Right,
they'll get really frustrated with that kind of inconsistency jumping back and forth.
It's Mother Nature.
It's remarkable how good these models are, honestly.
Exactly. I still can't believe how accurate everything is and that we knew it was going to come 5 days early. Alex Tardy, we thank you as always, and thanks for everything you do. We appreciate you.
Thank you.
Bye, Alex.
Thank you all.
Yeah.
Bye.